Greetings, everybody across the globe. First, we say hello to friends in Pacific, and then we go to the West Coast, 1 o'clock, and then after that, East Coast, 4 o'clock, and then to Scandinavia, Sweden, Norway, Denmark, friends there. Then we go to Deutschland, Germany, and the Balkans. Thank you for joining us. Very exciting to do the music from the recently remastered Street Scene CD. And the drummer on the CD is none other than Akira Tana. And the bassist was Larry Grenadier. We have very able, excellent bassist, Mr. Ken Okada today. And also on the CD, we have two excellent Latin percussionists, Hector Lugo, Vince Delgado. So Akira will be supplying all the Latin stuff. He does it all. Good news, the CD is on the charts. It hit the number one spot. So hopefully it keeps moving. Thank you for joining us. We're going to start with the opening track dedicated to Dexter Gordon. Dexter's Mode.
Thank you.
sorry.
Fire.
I turned up the volume. Maybe it could come down. Testing, testing. Sorry about that. I turned up the piano volume a little bit, so that activated. Okay, let's hope it'll be better now. Anyway, Dexter's Mode, I mentioned before, first time I played with Dexter Gordon was in 1963 in Copenhagen at the Montmartre Club, and there was so much history that I've learned besides hearing him play such great melodic bebop language. And he would talk about John Coltrane and Sonny Rollins. He would call them my sons. He mentioned that because when they first started playing, they played in the Dexter style. And what is interesting later is all the great musicians who don't stand still, they move up. Dexter, when he came back after 16 years in Europe, started playing modal music. He got influenced by one of his followers, John Coltrane. So this is called Dexter Mode. The first part is all one chord, C minor. And as all the great musicians, they are always not insecure. They praise all kinds of people from different ethnic groups. I told Dexter I just played with Mel Torme. He said he's great. And all of a sudden, he praised a Glenn Miller tenor player. Tex Beneke, dance band, but Tex Beneke was influenced by none other than Coleman Hawkins. So, and he gave me a great advice. He said, make your playing solos more percussive. Thank you, Dexter. The next selection from the CD is the title track, Street Scene. Street Scene is used in many 20th century Fox film noirs. I'll tell you about it in a minute.
Thank you.
tune represents kind of a lonely New York street scene, person walking late at night, and has a bluesy feeling, written by 20th Century Fox film composer Alfred Newman, not to be confused with the Mad magazine Alfred E. Newman. And a lot of great films. I suggest you check out Dark Corner with Lucille Ball and Mark Stevens. Great film, and she looked beautiful, 1946. Also, Where the Sidewalk Ends, Gene Turney, Dana Andrews, Otto Preminger film. You hear the theme. And the word street scene, what happens in the city. Also in jazz, the word scene, hey, the cat made a scene, he's visible. And who doesn't make it? Hey, he didn't make the scene. Also, there are a lot of film noir terms that are kind of funny. Right now, we go next to a legendary bebop blue note pianist, Sonny Clark, who did spend time in San Francisco. This is his original News for Lulu. We'll be right back. better call Alexei to help me one second. You didn't get a chance and everything is... you have to excuse one second, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, Alexei. I'm gonna turn off this. Didn't get a chance to do it and things are off balance. Sorry.
It sounds like the mic is gonna feed back. Oh, there's Alexei.
Hey, Alexei.
Yeah.
I wonder, sorry, we have to, the piano is a little bit low, and yeah, I wonder if you can take a look, Alexei. I had to turn up the master, but it's making the mic hum. Channel 2, yeah, correct. And maybe I have the...
I think you had it backwards. The mic is on channel 1.
See, is the mic on channel 1?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. That's what happened. Mm. Oh, jeez. Okay, just one second. Okay, sorry about that. I'm going to start off again. Sorry, I had it reversed. Wait one second. Testing 1, 2, testing 1, 2. That's why. Testing 1, 2, one more time. Testing 1, 2, one more. Okay, hopefully now we'll get it worked out. Okay, the next selection, I think we'll do I'll Wait and Pray, then we'll do the Mambo after that. The next selection is from the Billy Eckstein Big Band. It's a bebop ballad written by the valve trombonist Jerry Valentine. And it has unusual harmonic changes, not based on any standard tune. It's called I'll Wait and Pray, recorded by Sarah Vaughan, also John Coltrane. Okay, now I'll take a test one. No wonder, I guess. Thank you. I think finally we got the sound balance. I'm sorry about mixing up these numbers on the amplifier. Let's see, hopefully I'm getting it right now.
Yeah, sounds great.
Now, finally, beautiful solo, Ken. Thank you, thank you. Okay, Casablanca theme, very famous from 1931 by a gentleman, Herman Hupfeld, 1942, and I had the idea a while back, and I've been playing it as a mambo. I think it works well as a mambo. So here is, as time goes by, mambo. Thank you. I've said it before, but this is perfect time. One of the most versatile, stylistic drummers who plays everything with authenticity, Akira Tano. Thank you. No, this is true. Mambo, Brazil, Bebop. This cat did 5 albums with Lena Horne. That tells you something. Heath Brothers. And I have to say,
it went up to 20.
No, it goes up to 20. Now I need to compliment Ken Okada. He's got to get some bread too.
Yes, no. He's got to put his own word.
Great bass player plays again. He's Akira's partner in the group Otonova, wonderful group of ethnic Japanese music combined with jazz. Oh boy, these cats are doing a great job. Once again, I apologize for reversing the numbers for now. Should have had a sound set at the beginning. Anyway, I've learned something. Next, my tribute from the CD to the great Red Garland. I had a fortune to meet him at the jazz workshop, and I, in the aisle, I said, Red, how do you voice your chords? He doesn't know me, he spells it out. Left hand, this and that. I go home, oh man, great stuff. And I would see him different times, we would talk, and a great versatile pianist also. He's the guy that introduced those block chords to Miles. He brought great tunes to him that who would ever think of playing Bye Bye Blackbird? But he made it very modern. And who recommended John Coltrane to Miles? Red Garland. How many of you know he was a professional boxer? 48 bouts, also with Sugar Ray Robinson exhibition. However, he didn't affect his hands. He had the most beautiful, delicate touch. So here it is, the recording that he took, the song that he took by Spencer Williams from 1915, I Ain't Got Nobody. He had a great record with Charlie Persip and Sam Jones. Thank you. phrases that I kept using. It's a bebop phrase. Well, it translated, who parked the car? Who parked the car? Anyway, there's a lot of jazz language with the bebop phrasing. Great drumming. Ken Okada. Whoa. At this time, it's on the CD. I'd like to pay a quick tribute to Bill Evans. I had the fortune of meeting first in London, then in Italy when I was playing with Philly Joe. The last time I saw Bill before he passed away was the late 70s at the Great American Music Hall on O'Farrell. Noel Jukes and I were alternating sets with him. And we had a nice talk, recalled the old days. And all of a sudden, Bill was a very kind and gentleman who did not boast, but he quietly couldn't help it. He said, you know, I did basically all the work on Kind of Blue. Miles knew what he needed because he could hear. He knew Red Garland, that it was helping me recognize Bill Evans' new concept of impressionistic harmonies, modal usage. Kind of Blue, the highest selling CD in history. So Bill Evans runs it to Miles on the street. He said, Miles, how about some royalties? I'll send you a check. $25. Insult. Well, that's the way it is. Miles, I loved his playing, particularly in the 50s. He did have, as Sonny Rollins said, Miles had something different. He really did. His phrasing, later on, he always played good, but for me, I preferred the other stuff. Unfortunately, he had a habit of ripping people's tunes, clean head, and he put his name on this Bill Evans tune, Blue and Green. Well, that's the way it is. Here is Bill Evans, Blue and Green. Thank you. balance, blue and green. Next we go to Harold Arlen, Come Rain or Come Shine, and John Hendricks was the first to tell me about Harold Arlen's background. One second. He said Harold Arlen's father was a cantor at the synagogue. Right next to the synagogue was a Baptist church where you hear all the authenticity before the blues that connected. So Harold Arlen heard both things. And to me, he was about the basic standard composer closest to the blues. Blues in the Night, this tune, Come Rain or Come Shine, has those elements. And he also wrote very sophisticated tunes Last Night While We Were Young. And here is Come Rain or Come Shine, also all of this music on the Street Scene CD.
Thank you.
also is used after a piano solo for the bass. We did this in Serbia at a concert, and everybody in the trio stopped because they thought it was the ending. Anyway, great job, cats. Two more tunes. I need to tell you a joke. Some people haven't heard it. A piano player was playing at a mob, a place run by the mob, where they talk on the side of the mouth, and the guy came. The boss wants to hear come rain or come shine, and if you know what's good for you, you better play both of them. Thank you, Akira. Anyway, here is Jimmy Van Heusen, one of the great composers. From the late 30s, he did this tune, Oh, You Crazy Moon. Sophisticated harmonies. Also, he did It Could Happen to You, Deep in a Dream. Here is Our Rainy Day. This is Oh, You Crazy Moon. We recorded it as a bolero. It fits nicely as a romantic bolero tempo. one of the recordings of this tune, Chet Baker, no matter what he did, such great melodic, instrumental and singing concept. I was called to play with him. Akira, I remember in late 80s club, Whippoorwill in New York. Yeah, they opened big. MJQ, Stan Getz, so they blew their budget right away. Anyway, what happened? I was called to play with him, but I heard they were behind payroll, so I turned it down. But I did sit in with him. Harold Danko was kind to let me. He was playing piano, great band. Mm-hmm. Ben Riley on drums, trying to remember, also a good bass player. Anyway, I sat in. And that's the last time I saw him. He passed away in Amsterdam. But what is interesting to me, Miles, in my opinion, turned left. He played all that fusion stuff. Some of it was okay, but nothing to the level that he played before. And Charlie Rice, the great drummer who is in Miles' book, he played like Kenny Clark, but he was a tailor. So Miles wanted suits he made, but this cat wasn't afraid of Miles. He said, "Miles, why are you playing that shit?" He said, "Oh, the people like it. It's good money." Anyway, but see, Chet Baker never sold out. Mm-hmm. Till the end, he was pure. That's my opinion. Anyway, as we close each performance, I thank everybody for listening. Street Scene, as I mentioned, is number 21, and hopefully it'll get even better. You can go to my website to get it. And the last tune is Scandinavian Waltz. Before that, on the screen, you have PayPal donation. If you can donate anything, it goes to the cats in the trio. Thank you so much. And this tune was interesting. I played with a Norwegian lady that Akira played too, on Bistro 339, Bodil, the Norwegian tenor player, and she had a festival in Norway, and my son Alexi and I flew. So what happened, we spent a little time in Copenhagen with Palle Mikkelborg, great Danish musician, trumpet player, who arranged for Miles. We recalled the old days, and on the plane to Stockholm, I was falling asleep, but this melody came. Luckily, I had a little hand recorder, otherwise I would have forgotten. So I dedicated this song, Scandinavian Waltz, to all great Danish cats and Norwegian. Palle Mikkelborg, Bent Yedig, Neil Senegersted Pedersen, Karin Krog, wonderful Norwegian singer, and Bodil, Scandinavian Waltz. Thank you. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you, thank you. Thank you.
Hey, Vuckovich.
Thank you, thank you. Thank you, Alexei.